What's going on, guys? I actually thought I'd give you guys some commentary and inside context to what actually went down and what went wrong with my overall physique for this competition. Now, there's a lot of factors that actually went into it, but we're going to break it down and we're going to get right into it. So first off, you guys may or may not know, my competition was right before COVID actually happened, and that was kind of a downplay in my actual physique. So as the weeks and days went by, I did not give it my all. I was not doing my cardio. I wasn't running. I was supposed to be doing around 15 to 20 minutes of cardio. I didn't actually do any of that. So that was the first factor that went into my physique. My second biggest mistake was taking a flexible dieting approach to my overall competition. Guys, this is the worst thing that you can do, that if it fits your macros. I know that works for some people, but in the long run, when you're doing a competition prep, that is not the actual approach that you want to be taking. My foods that I was eating, I was guesstimating for a while, and guesstimating is not something that you should do. Another thing that actually went into my diet that I actually did that was horrible, when my coach said to have a cheat meal, I didn't actually know what a cheat meal entailed, and I actually just went deep, and I just went to go get it. I got a pizza and wings. I would go to McDonald's. I would get a burger and fries. I didn't know a cheat meal was just to boost your leptin levels, just a burger or something. In my next prep, most likely I will eliminate cheat meals altogether because they are not needed. They are needed for some people when your metabolism slows down, but that's a different subject. For me, I will not be having cheat meals at all the next time I do a competition prep. My last one definitely was my posing. It's something that I actually avoided because I was just nervous overall. So I would do posing once every couple of weeks. So when I finally got on stage, my posing was not on point. You can even see there was areas that I didn't mess up on. And that was a factor in the determining place that I actually did get on stage. But you know, next year I will just come back stronger and better. But overall, it was a good experience. But take these tips into account. Don't make the same mistakes I did, because if you're trying to win a competition, you need to be going 110%. I was into this about 80%. So if you guys, I listed four things out, if you guys do all of those four things, your next competition or your first competition will definitely be better than I will. Don't take the flexible dieting approach. There won't be another quarantine time that you guys decide to do your competition. Get it done. Do what you need to do. You guys got this. I'm gonna see you guys in the next video.